Mr. Stevet, Joss, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I am from the countryside of Tangshanzu. He is the Oriental Shakespeare. I'm deeply privileged to be here to talk about natural cabinet, this truly important issue. First of all, I'm very honored to talk about the beautiful city of Fuzhou. The city of Fuzhou is located in Jiangxi province, eastern part of Jiangxi province. Right now we have 4 million people with the area of 16.8 kilometers square. We can talk about Fuzhou with abundant culture, because Fuzhou has been known as the birthplace of Wang Shi, Tang Shanzu, and other cultural megaheads. First persons, Mr. Wang Anshi was called as the reformer in the 11th century China, whereas Mr. Tang Xianzu was rewarded and earned as the Shakespeare in the East. Tomorrow during the performance, tomorrow night we will have three artists to talk about Tang Xianzu's drama plays. Secondly, we have abundant products and we have great characteristics. We are the birthplace and the agricultural stronghold of China. We have Mandarin oranges from Nanfu, we have white lotus from Guangzhou, and the matcha chicken from Chongren. These are very famous agricultural products in China. Thirdly, we have beautiful environment and is suitable for living. So we have a lot of forest lands, and we have even certain places have 80% of the forest land, and we have great quality of our air. We have great percentage of our O3 concentration. So we have been awarded as a National Garden City and National Forest City. And fourthly, we have superior location and cooking and transportation. From the very beginning, we are located in a very logistically location, because we are located in the Yangtze River Delta, the Pearl River Delta, and the Southeast Fusion Delta, and we are very easily centrally located to different oceans and rivers. And recently, our city government has promoted to have a different kind of ecological civilization to make sure that we will have a lot of different ecological processes and programs so that we can be a model city around the nation. And first of all, we have a serious work of ecological projects, and we vigorously promote ecological and urban repair and restoration. On one hand, we have a series of different ecological projects. In a long time, we have enhanced in governing our mountains, regulating our water, so we have various different ecological restoration projects so that we can further maintain our beautiful sceneries and natural resources. And also, we promoted an implementation project for Fuzhou City's ecological civilization model program, so that we want to make sure that people and the nature will be lived in harmony with one another. And also we have 36 different villages. We've viewed them as the pilot villages, and we have different kind of ideas to make sure that we have ecological villages and townships. We want to, in 3 years, we'll be able to establish these villages and townships to have its own ecological attractions. And right now, we want to make sure that the ecological environment will be greatly enhanced due to this effort. Earlier on, we talked about the different smaller scale of the ecological protection efforts. And through planting different different water plants. We are better managing our water canals. And right now, our regional water quality maintained really good to level 2 to 3, and the clarity of our visibility of the water reaches about 3 meters. And also, the coverage of our water plants are very wide. So if you're interested, you can take a look in this regard about our efforts in the water environment. And also, we conduct a lot of different ecological efforts in restoration efforts. We have different protection mechanisms so that we can be able to make sure to overcome ecological challenges. For instance, make sure the forest coverage will reach about 61%, and for the entire Jiangxi province is about 63%, so we are about 3% higher than the provincial average. And also for the red line or control line of the ecological efforts, so it accounts about 32.3% of the national land, and we want to make sure the garbage disposal and manage rate, and we have different mechanisms to reach our goal that by 2020 we will be able to have a recycling and water cleaning system of the level 3. And also we want to make sure that our water, our soil, and our air are further cleaned. And we want to make sure that our climates and our days are great, are livable. And we want to make sure that we have 1,104 reservoirs and water structures will be able to match the level 2 area and make sure that the usage percentage will reach 100%.
Above
mentioned efforts were only a glimpse of our effort. And we want to make sure that if we work together, we'll be able to have some rewards and outcomes, and then we can further enhance the value of the ecological systems and further elaborate that. We are a low-carbon city. We also have been recognized a pilot city of the Fuzhou Xinshan, and also the largest mountain will be able to transfer into an invaluable asset. Ecological development is a must. We need to transfer our methods to do that. President Xi Jinping talked about how we should maintain our green mountains and waters into an invaluable asset. So in Fuzhou City, we want to make sure that during this transformation, we'll put our effort, we'll make our part, we will need to maintain our lush mountains and lose the water and maintain and make sure that our ecological advantages will be transferred into the economical advantages. Make sure that we will further enhance our conservation efforts so that we will be able to enhance our efficiency of ecological efforts, and we will make sure that the organic and ecological agriculture will be further enhanced. Also, we will be able to make sure the supply efforts to our agricultural products. We can see this chart that
so this is part of our organic green agriculture development. So for the whole city, we have over 37,000 more of those organic green development. So we have organic products, 22 of them. And we proactively support the companies to develop a new organic green agriculture way. We also promote any innovations in terms of agriculture development. And Dongxiang County, we have a special company, and they try to compromise and reconcile those contradictions between economic development and ecological conservation. And in Chuan, they are also developing a very special way to grow plants. And in a rotating way, for example, they grow plants, different plants at different timings. So they hope to promote their planting and food processing and provide a very high quality agricultural products. And one thing to mention is that So we developed our agricultural products. We try to leverage our ecological resources, for example, our white lotus, our different animals, and hope to develop our technology and use technology to promote these special agricultural products to alleviate poverty and help more households and more farmers to grow their business and income. And also we are hoping to promote our advanced manufacturing. And we hope to upgrade the whole industrial supply chain. And also for the whole traceability system, we are hoping to spend a lot of effort and make investment to upgrade the whole industry to a higher level. So our city has established the very first government procuring service platform in the whole province. For example, the cloud computing center is taking is in operation, and we spend over 5 billion RMB and 4.5 billion to establish a digital computing center. And we hope to promote big data, and we also invested 2.5 billion RMB on electronics. And also for the new industry, we spend a lot of efforts. We spend 4.5 billion RMB on the new automotive. We try to establish a comprehensive industrial chain surrounding new vehicles and new energy to promote the advanced manufacturing development in the whole city. So we actually work with Fudan University to start a laboratory. For example, we also develop a lot of pharmaceutical products for cardiovascular disease, and among others. So we try to leverage the educational resources from the university to promote our business, our tourism, and our culture as well. And we hope to establish a very comprehensive modern service industry. And from the cultural innovation perspective, we also have a lot of innovations. We hope to build more brands and drive our cultural development. So we actually organized a few events surrounding the historical figure Hongxing and attracted a lot of foreigners to come over and know more about our culture. We hope to promote our local culture and literature and promote it to the whole world. And also we focus on our cultural components to make it to transform that into a brand, a strong cultural brand. And make it a global brand as well. We also have a very special Nuo dance, as well as other intangible cultural heritage. So we hope to revitalize our traditional Chinese culture and literature. And in terms of green development, we are also developing green financing. We develop a national level financial innovations, and from the recreational perspective, we try to preserve our 5,000 years of history and develop and maintain our local cultural flavors, and some of the areas are regarded as a protection zone. We hope to retain the local authentic flavor and the cultural components. And some of the places, for example, Caoshan Temple is considered as a national level protection area to be a tourist destination. We are also trying to establish certain national level ancient villages to become a tourist attraction. And from the cultural perspective, as well as from the healthcare perspective, we are also using digital health and telehealth, and working with local research institutions and companies to provide healthcare examination and other services to our residents in our city. Over 500 medical offices, over 40 health centers. We also have we also have 10 county level hospitals. They all joined our digital health initiative. And the third is our innovation system and the summary of experience, how we can come up with the best practices. Jiangxi province is a very important province for ecological development. We have a strong natural advantages to become the leading example of ecological protection. So we have a lot of innovations and the best practices. So we have the innovation mechanism, we have a platform, we have a lot of work taking place to utilize our innovation capabilities. We are the very first city in the province to establish a green GDP mechanism as well as the relevant assessment model. We hope to realize the value of our ecological products and have a measurable result. So a lot of works are taking place. For example, in Fuzhou, we established a public service platform on the mobile phone. We hope to encourage our residents to pay attention to ecology. And also people, they can actually take care of their health through the internet. If people adopt a green style or low carbon lifestyle, they can be incentivized or they will be given incentives or bonuses. So currently, the platform is already in operation. We also have ecology cloud, the platform. We try to leverage big data and the power of the internet to better monitor the overall ecology of the city. And for the Jiangxi province, we try to meet the standard of the province. We also have a strong effective balance sheet based on technology to meet all the metrics and the parameters in terms of the water, air, and to closely monitor all the metrics. And also for any environmental damage, we have a reporting system as well. And the other thing is that we have a bold exploration into the reform of the ecological judicial system. So to combine an ecological public safety and public judicial process as well. And also we have very strong responsibilities among different departments and very strong accountability. And to jointly deal with those ecological challenges, we also have some tailored programs. For example, combining agriculture, forest, and other six different components, we hope to better monitor and manage the whole forestation status of the whole city. And for any bad behaviors, we have a punishment mechanism as well to prevent any damage from taking place. So later on, our city will have further mechanism and exploration in terms of better prevent those damages. Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, Fuzhou is a very important city in terms of our ecological development. We have our strong and unique cultural components. We have great potential in China. So we have a very bright future. I invite all of you to pay a visit to Fuzhou, give us feedback, and to experience our very beautiful scenery, our very unique culture, and our very rich natural resources. Thank you very much.